Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We bless God for today. We give God the glory. We give God all honor, all adoration. We thank God for another day. Today He has made a beautiful day. We give God all the glory, all adoration, all honor. To Him alone be all the glory. We worship You, our Father. We thank You for the gift of life. We thank You for bringing us together. We thank You for our listeners. We thank You for coming to see us again. You have not come to meet with any man. You have come to meet with God, the Almighty God, the one who created you and who created you for His own purpose. We give God the glory. Hallelujah. Before we go ahead today, let's just take this song. Let's take this song together. Hallelujah. Amen. We give God all the glory. Hallelujah. As we await the coming of our Lord Jesus, let's just sing this song together. Amen. One glorious morning, I shall see my Savior. One glorious morning, by and by. One glorious morning, I shall see my Redeemer. One glorious morning, by and by. One glorious morning, you shall see your Redeemer. One glorious morning, by and by. One glorious morning, we shall see our Redeemer. One glorious morning, by and by. One glorious morning, we shall see our Savior Jesus. One glorious morning, by and by. Amen. One glorious morning, you shall see your Savior. One glorious morning, I shall see my Savior. One glorious morning, we shall see our Savior, Jesus Christ. When we remain faithful, Lord Jesus, we pray for your grace. We pray for your grace to do everything for us to see you that glorious morning. For us to see your face smiling at us, telling us, well done, you faithful servant, O God. Almighty King of Glory, we pray that glorious morning, that faithful day, we shall see you in glory with smiles all around us. With smiles, with joy, with peace forevermore. And you shall welcome us home. You shall welcome us home. You shall welcome us home in the name of Jesus. Father, our trust is in you. Our hope is in you. We need your grace to run this race and run it and win it gloriously. In the name of Jesus. Father, this day we are praying for grace, for enablement, for strength, for empowerment. Oh God, for us to do everything right, to make our things right before your arrival, before your coming, so that we shall not miss it, we shall not miss that glorious day, we shall not miss that glorious morning, we shall not miss that glorious heaven that we are all waiting for, in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit divine, we pray, search through us, come through us, and if there is anything in us that will not allow us, that will not make us to meet heaven, to be in heaven, Father, reveal to us, O God, and help us to make amends, to rectify our ways in the name of Jesus. Help us to make things right. Father, we pray in the name of Jesus. King of Glory, you want to commit today's message to your mighty hands, Holy Spirit divine. Have your way, Holy Spirit. Speak through me, Holy Spirit. I do not want to speak my word, that which you have put in my mouth, O Lord. That I will speak. I cover your message, your word, with the blood of Jesus. I cover my soul with the blood of Jesus. I cover the equipment we are using and everything attached to it with the blood of Jesus. I cover this place everywhere here with the precious blood of Jesus. We come against every principality, every power that wants to be limited against your plan, your will concerning your children. We pray it shall not stand in Jesus' name. We pray, O Lord God Almighty, that your word will pierce through every joint and marrow, O God, of your children, and they will listen to this message, and they will make corrections to their lives in the name of Jesus. Father, that glorious morning, we shall not be disappointed. We shall not be disappointed. We shall not hear surprises, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, give us the grace to run this race and to win it gloriously in Jesus' name. Holy Spirit divine. The hour has come to glorify the Father, to glorify the Son, in the name of Jesus. Have your way in our midst, O God. Have your way this day. Speak through me. Holy Spirit, possess me afresh, O God. I protect Jesus Christ. I protect Jesus Christ as the flesh be subjected now, under the leading of the Holy Spirit now, in the name of Jesus. Spirit divine, have your way. Take control. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. Amen. I'm so excited for the gift of life. I'm alive today. You are alive today. And that is the reason why you are listening to this message. Amen. I give God the glory. I give God the honor. I give God all adoration, for Him alone is worthy. The Lord is worthy of all praise. Our Lord is worthy of all honor. I want to welcome you once again to New Life in Christ. We give God the glory. Hallelujah. He has kept us, and now He has brought us again to come and hear from Him. Amen. Hallelujah. We bless God. We bless God. The Lord is faithful. Amen. Today, by the grace of God, we'll go straight to to the message the Lord has for us today. Amen. Because I know if you have been following us, if you have not been following us, please, you need to go and listen to the other messages that have been posted on this forum. The first one was the mandate of heaven. The mandate of heaven, after mandate of heaven, repentance from the edge. After repentance from the edge, physician, heal yourself. After physician, heal yourself, sanctification after salvation. So if you have not listened to any of those things, you have to listen to it before this message. Amen. Because this message is for those that have already followed through and are faithfully doing the will of the Lord. Amen. So, today, by the grace of God, say, now that you are saved, now that you are sanctified, because we are talking to believers today. And if you are not yet surrender your life to Christ, I pray by the end of this message, you will surrender your life to Christ in Jesus' name. Amen. So, now that you are saved, now that you are sanctified, have you thought about the wrongs you did before you gave your life to Christ? Have you thought about the wrongs you did before you gave your life to Christ? Thank God you are saved now. Thank God you are sanctified. Thank God we are waiting for the arrival of our Lord Jesus Christ. But have you ever thought about those wrongs you did before you gave your life to Christ? Have you thought about the repercussion, those wrong things you did has brought to you, or to the person you did the wrong to, or to the people you did the wrong to, or to the situation, as the case may be? Have you thought about the repercussion that wrong things you did has brought to you as a person, or to another person, or to the group of people, or to a society, or concerning any situation at all? Have you thought about going back to the person, to the people, to the organization, to the society, to the situation, and make things right? Have you thought about that and make amends? Have you thought about that? I want to ask this morning, this day, whatever the time you have, I want to ask, is your conscience cleared? Do you have a clear conscience? Do you have a clear conscience? Is your conscience cleared? Do you have doubting mind about past situation? Since we have surrendered your life to Christ, you have been sanctified, you have been cleansed, you have been sanctified. Do you have doubting mind about the past situation? since you are saved? Do you like, I did something right? Do you have it? Since you are saved, do you have peace with God? Do you have peace with all men? Do you have peace with God in your heart? Do you have peace with all men? Is your mind void of offense? Is your mind, is it void of offense? Is your heart void of offense? If indeed you have surrendered your life to Christ and you are a heaven seeker, if you are a heaven seeker and you have been sanctified spirit, soul and body, and you have been sanctified spirit, soul and body, if your heart is circumcised indeed, if your heart has been circumcised indeed, and you have not done or attempted to make things right, things that was wrong before, you have not done or attempted to make them right, then the time to do it is now. The time to do it is now. If you answer yes to any of the questions I have asked, then this the right time for you to do and make things right is now by the grace of God. Do not delay anymore because tomorrow may not come. Tomorrow may not come both for you and for the people involved. What about the people involved if they are no more and you have not yet made things right? So tomorrow may not come both for you and the people involved. Have you thought about restitution? That is where I'm going. Have you thought about restitution? Restitution frees you from bondage. Restitution, it frees you from bondage of heart. It frees you from bondage of heart and bondage of mind. It frees you of any wrong situation you must have found yourself. Restitution frees you from any wrong situation you may find yourself. Restitution is divine. Restitution is divine and restitution is approved of God. Restitution is approved of God. Let's look at our Bible in the book of Leviticus. Leviticus, we'll be reading Leviticus this morning, chapter 6. Leviticus chapter 6, we'll be reading from verses 1 to 7. From verses 1 to 7, I read. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, if a soul sin and commit a trespass against the Lord, and lie unto his neighbor in that which was delivered him to keep, or in fellowship, or in a thing taken away by violence, or hath deceived his neighbor, or hath found that which was lost, and lieth concerning it, and sweareth falsely, in any of all this that a man doeth, sinning therein, then it shall be, because he hath sinned and is guilty, that he shall restore that which he took violently away, or the thing which he had deceitfully gotten, or that which was delivered him to keep, or the lost thing which he found, or all that about which he had sworn falsely. He shall even restore it in the principal, and shall add the fifth part more thereto, and he shall and give it unto him to whom is a penance in the day of his trespass offering. And he shall bring his trespass offering unto the Lord, a ram without blemish, out of the flock, with thy estimation, for a trespass offering unto the priest. Verse 7. And the priest shall make an atonement for him before the Lord, and he shall be forgiven him for anything of all that he had done in trespassing therein. You see, brethren, this is the word of the Lord concerning the people, the children of Israel. He spoke to Moses here about restitution. So you can see here that restitution is divine. Restitution is approved of God. Restitution of all those things. We are going to read again the book of Acts. The book of Acts, Acts chapter 24. Acts, the book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter 24, verse 16. Acts of the Apostles 24, verse 16, and it says, "And herein do I exercise myself to have always a conscience void of offense toward God and toward men." You see here, "And herein do I exercise myself to have always a conscience void of offense toward God and toward men." Is your conscience clear? Is your heart clear? Do you have peace with God? Do you have peace with men? Today, by the grace of God, you will know where you stand in the name of Jesus. Amen. Therefore, today, our topic is restitution for heaven seekers. Our topic today is restitution for heaven seekers. Restitution for heaven seekers. We can see in the first passage how God instructed Moses on restitution. You know, how God told him everything, something that if you tell someone that stole something, what you will do, if you bear false witness, what you will do, and all that. So now, let us go. What is restitution itself? What is restitution? Let's see what restitution is. Restitution is making right the wrongdoing. Restitution is making right the wrongdoings. Revisiting the wrong old situation. Revisiting the wrong old situation and making it the right new situation. Restitution is the evidence that you are a new person. Restitution is the evidence that you are a new person, that indeed all things are passed away. It is the evidence of salvation. It is to make good the damage you did in the past. Restitution is to make good the damage you did in the past. It is to make good the damage you did in the past. It is to uncover evil deeds done in secret. All those evil deeds you did in the secret, it is to uncover them. Restitution makes you to uncover evil deeds done in secret to bring them open. It is a continuous process whereby you restitute the past and make sure you do not overlook the present. Restitution is a continuous process whereby you restitute the past and you make sure you do not overlook the present. Amen. Some people cannot even say, "I'm sorry for the wrong they did." Some people can't say, "I'm sorry for the wrong I did. Oh, I did that, I'm sorry." Some people cannot do that. They can't say, "I'm sorry." You know, those people cannot make heaven. Those people cannot make heaven. You have to be sincerely sorry for any wrong you did. You have to be sincerely sorry for any wrong you did. Restitution may cost you your job. I have to be frank with you. I have to let you know the real fact. Restitution may cost you your job. It may cost you your marriage. It may cost you friendship. Yes. It may cost you friendship. But I tell you, it is just for a moment. It is just for a moment, because at the end of it all, you will gain much more back. You will gain much more back by being faithful. You will remain faithful, and that guarantees you eternal life. If you do your restitution right and you remain faithful with the Lord, that guarantees you eternal life when you do it according to the leading of the Holy Spirit. Restitution must never be done in the flesh. Restitution must never be done in the flesh. The Lord, the Holy Spirit will lead you on how to do your restitution and to do it right. Restitution is a must for all heaven seekers. Because that is why this message is for heaven seekers. If you want to get to heaven, this message on restitution is for you by the grace of God. If you have not done your restitution, or you have forgotten about one or two of them, this message will help you by the grace of God. Amen. So the message is for heaven seekers. Restitution is difficult to do, especially when life is involved. especially when blood has been shed. It is difficult to do, but with much prayer and counseling. Because in such a case, you need much more prayer. You need counseling. And I pray the Lord God Almighty will give you right counselors that will direct you aright in the name of Jesus. You know, and know by the grace of God, the Lord will help you in Jesus' name. Restitution gives you rest of mind. Restitution gives you rest of mind. Restitution gives you peace. Oh, restitution gives you peace and gives you assurance of tomorrow. Restitution gives you assurance of tomorrow. It gives you rest of mind. It gives you peace. Restitution, repentance without restitution is not a complete one. If you say you have repented and you have not done your restitution, it's not complete. So repentance without restitution is like a house without a roof or windows. You know, repentance without restitution is like a house without a roof or without windows. So anything can happen to the occupants of the house. When the rain falls, it will fall on them. The trees can break in any time. Different types of things that can happen to a house without a roof or windows. So repentance and restitution must go together. Repentance and restitution must go together. Amen. For you to make restitution, you need to first realize your wrongdoing. Amen. For you to make restitution, you need to first realize you have done something wrong. If you do not realize you have done something wrong, there is no way you can make restitution. So for you to do restitution, you must first realize you have wronged some people or you have done something wrong. After that, then you'll be determined to restitute. After that, be determined to restitute. Confess it and pay back. After that, you have to determine to restitute. Confess it and pay back. The Lord will give you the grace in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Now, we are going to look at areas where restitution is necessary. Areas where restitution is necessary. I just have about five of them here today. Five of them. I said restitution is necessary in the area of career. In your career, in your individual life. That's number two. Number three, in the area of stealing. You know, stolen items, those things. That's number three. Number four, in the area of ministry. And number five, in the area of marriage. Those are the 5 points we are going to discuss today by the grace of God. So number one is in the area of career. You know, in case you are looking for a job and you have changed your age, either you have reduced your age or you've added to your age so that you can fit into that position, you need to restitute. I will repeat myself. If you have applied for a job, especially there are some countries that you declare your age in your resume, in your curriculum, right there, you declare your age. Or they say they need so-so age from this age bracket. And you know you did not fit into it. But because you needed a job so bad, you reduced your age or you added to your age for you to fit in to that position they are making requests on. Then you need to go back to that company, to that organization, and confess to them and make your restitution right. Amen. Let us read the book of Revelation, because all these things we are saying, they are all written in the Bible. Let's read the book of Revelation. Revelation chapter 21 verse 27. I read, "And there shall in no wise enter into it anything that defileth, neither whatsoever worketh abomination, or make it a lie, but they which are written in the Lamb's book of life." Did you see that? Because if you reduce your head, you have lied. You have told a lie. And all liars, they go to hell. All liars, they have their own part in the pits of hell. It says here, "There shall be no vice enter into it." Not at all. By no means may a liar enter into heaven. Not at all. Nor anything that defileth. You know, Neither whatsoever worketh abomination, or maketh a lie, but they which are written in the Lamb's book of life. So if you have lied in the area of seeking job, you are looking for a job, you have lied either in age or in your CV, in anything at all, you must go back now and do your restitution. The Lord God Almighty will help you in the name of Jesus. If you have false certificates, or you cheated during an exam, you know, some countries, cheating is so rampant, because this message is for the whole world. It's for the whole world. So, if you have false certificates, or you have cheated during an exam, or someone else wrote your exams for you, someone else wrote your papers for you, you must restitute now. If you want to get to heaven, you must do your restitution, complete your restitution, and be ready for Christ. If someone sat for your exam, or sat for exam on your behalf, the exam was written in your name, you did not sit for the exam, someone else sat for the exam, now you have the false certificate, or you forged your certificate, you need to do your restitution now. You need to go to the authorities in what and confess to them, this is what you did, make your restitution right. Or you do not even appear in school at all. There are some people, they are 4 years college, they are 5 years college, they are 7 years college. Maybe they appear 2, 3 years, 4 years, the final year they didn't appear, or during exams they don't even show up at all. In some countries they call them machineries, people will come and write your exams for you. They call them machineries in some countries, you know, they will come and write your exams for you in your name, but you did not even go to school. Or you went to school for a year or two and you just got fake results. You must go back to the institution and restitute now if you are an heaven seeker. If you did not appear in school at all, or someone else wrote all your exams, so even some people, they did not even write exam at all, either in secondary school, either in college, in university, in any year at all, that you did not write exam, or you cheated in any way in your exam, you must go back and restitute today. You know, some people, they even went for National Youth Service Corps. In some countries, they go and serve the nation. They only went for youth service, but they did not go to school, or they did not complete it. Someone else completed their studies for them. Someone else wrote their exams for them. You need to go back to the authority. Return that certificate you have gotten by force, because you got your certificate by force. It is false. It is not you that wrote the exams. You are not worthy to have that certificate you are carrying. So you now have certificates of which you did not work for. You must restitute. If you have cheated in one way or the other to obtain that position, you must do your restitution now if you are an heaven seeker. If you present first results, repent and restitute today. I pray the Holy Spirit will begin to remind you of anyone that cannot remember or that will not be mentioned here. But in your career, in your anything you do, anything pertaining to that, if you have lied, you have cheated, you have presented any false results, you have presented any false certificates, or you are working based on false falsehood, please go back, restitute, and the Lord will grant you the grace in the name of Jesus. Amen. We'll quickly go to number two. You know, the restitution is necessary in our individual life. In our individual lives, restitution is necessary. If you have traveled with false documents, that is where I will start from, because this part of the world I belong to, me, even myself, I'm not in my rightful country where I was born. I immigrated here. So if you have traveled with false documents, and now you are a child of God, I'm only talking to children of God here. I'm only talking to heaven seekers here. If you have traveled to that particular country you are with false documents, You have traveled outside of your original country with false documents. You must go and make restitution. Go to the government. Go to the institution involved. Let them know this is what you have done. This is what you did when you came into their country. Make your restitution, go and confess to them. If you are an heaven seeker, you must restitute. Even if it means going back to your own country. What can you lay on the altar for heaven? That would be too much. Because we are talking about heaven here, where we have eternal life. Where you will be there forever and ever. Only God knows how many billions of years we will be alive with God, with Christ. So what can you do today that is compared to that which you need, that you will later enjoy in life? That you will later enjoy in life. So you must do that. You can sacrifice that for your soul to be redeemed. If it means to go back to your own country, you can sacrifice that for your soul to be saved eternally. No suffering is worthy to be compared with the future glory. No suffering is worthy to be compared with the future glory. Let us read again the Bible in the book of Matthew. We are going to read Matthew chapter 12. Matthew 12:36. But I say unto you that every idle word that men shall speak, they shall give account thereof in the day of judgment. Because that is where we're going to now. Every idle word you have spoken, you are going to give accounts on the day of judgment. Every idle word will be judged. Every idle word will be judged. When you repent, you must go back and say, I told a lie. If you have told a lie, the lie that has now sent somebody to jail, that have now made somebody to suffer punishment, you must go back. Because every idle word will be judged. We read this in the book of Matthew now, chapter 12, verse 36. Every idle word will be judged. So if you have told a lie, you have to go back and tell yourself, oh, I told a lie. Have you torn families apart with the word of your mouth? With lying? Have you torn families apart? Have you told a lie to break or separate a home? Have you told a lie to break or separate a home? Oh, I pray the Holy Spirit begin to remind you of everything you have done in the past now in the name of Jesus. So that you can make and you will make heaven at last in the mighty name of Jesus. For everyone who is sincerely seeking heaven, the Holy Spirit divine will remind you of your past wrongdoings now in the mighty name of Jesus. So shall it be in Jesus' name. Amen. What about character assassination? Have you killed somebody with mere speaking, with mere word, by cooking up lies, by cooking up good stories, by cooking up stating fake things? Have you killed somebody with the word of mouth? Character assassination. You have killed that person. Though the person is still alive, but he's dead. Because you have killed the person with just the word of your mouth. Have you killed with the word of your mouth? All false witness you have made, you must go back and restitute. Any false witness, they are talking, say, hey, come, were you not there? This thing happened. I say, yes. Oh, yes, I was there. It happened. I was there. It happened. I saw it. Whereas you were lying. Every false witness you have made, you have to go back. Confess them and restitute. Confess them and restitute. The person or the people you have sent to jail, all that are in problem, all they have suffered punishment, all they have suffered punishment even now, because of your actions, you must go back, repent, and restitute. Every person or people or any situation that you are torn apart, you have brought shame, you have sent to jail, you have made them to suffer punishment unjustly. All those things you have made people to go through because of the word of man, because of evil words, because of false witness, because of angry words, because of a lie. You must go back, repent of them all, and do your restitution today. The Lord God Almighty will help you, my brother, my sister, in the name of Jesus. Amen. We will go to number 3. Restitution is necessary in the area of stolen items. Stealing. We are going to read Bible again. Because we must let our people know, because some people may not even know that this thing is wrong. They may not even know they need to do restitution, but they need to do it so that they can be in heaven. We are going to read the book of Judges. Judges chapter 17. We'll be reading verses 1 to 4. Judges chapter 17 from verses 1 to 4. Amen. And there was a man of Mount Ephraim, whose name was Micah, and he said unto his mother, the 1100 shekels of silver that were taken from thee, about which thou cuttest and speakest of, also in my ears, behold, the silver is with me. I took it. And his mother said, blessed be thou of the Lord, my son. And when he had restored the 1100 shekels of silver to his mother said, I had wholly dedicated the silver unto the Lord from my hand for my son to make a graven image and a molten image. Now therefore, I will restore it unto thee. Yet he restored the money unto his mother, and his mother took 200 shekels of silver and gave them to the founder, who made therefore thereof a graven image and a molten image, and they were in the house of Micah. You can see here that Micah stole his mother's 1100 shekels of silver. He stole. Imagine, even the mother cost. The time God Micah went back to say, mommy, you know what? I stole your money. Mommy, I stole your money. Here is it. He restored back to his mom. Micah restored the money he stole back to his mom. So you can see the example in the Bible. You can see the example in the Bible. Amen. In the book of Judges 17, verses 1 to 4 with Joshua. Can you see that the 11 shekels of silver taken by Micah, that was stolen by Micah from his mom, and the mom already cursed whoever stole it. The mommy already cursed. The mother already cursed. You might not even know. Maybe that thing you stole, the person cursed, laid a curse on whoever stole it. You may not even know. If you have stolen something in the past, how would you know if the person you stole it or good already laid a curse on whoever that stole it, and the person that stole it is you? How would you know if a curse has been laid on you because of that thing you stole long time ago? I pray the Lord God Almighty will help us in Jesus' name. But now you will be running from one church to another. But you won't break through. Something is happening to you. You have problems, this and that. Whereas your problem is, the solution to your problem is restitution. Because the person already laid a curse. And that curse will surely work on you if you did not make restitution. The only solution to that is for you to make restitution so that the curse can be removed. The only solution is for you to make restitution. I pray the Lord God Almighty will help you to make restitution in Jesus' name. So go and confess and be delivered. You need to go and confess and be delivered. Although you have done away with that thing you stole. Maybe money, you have spent the money long time ago. Or an item, you have used it long time ago. But the cost still remains. The cost still remains, brethren. The cost is still there. Until you do your restitution, you cannot be delivered from that cost. No matter how many deliverance you did, go and confess. Confess, do your restitution, and the cost will be removed from your life today in the name of Jesus. I know restitution requires shame. It's a shameful thing. You're like, how do I go back? How do I do this? How do I do that? I know it's a shameful thing. I know, no doubt about that. It is a shameful thing. But put that aside. If you want to get to heaven, put that aside and save your soul. Put that aside, brethren, and save your soul. Put that aside and save your soul. Because there is blessing in restitution, brethren. Brothers and sisters, there is blessing in restitution. There is deliverance in restitution. There is healing in restitution. Even and much more when you restitute. When you do your restitution, you have peace of mind. You have rest for your soul. If you have taken things wrongfully and without permission from the owner, you must restitute today. Anything you have taken wrongfully or without seeking permission, either from your organization, either from your neighbor, either from your friends, either from your parents, either from your family member, from anyone at all, wrongfully or without permission, you must do your restitution today. You must do your restitution today. That money you stole, that money taken from the library, the books you borrowed from your friends and you did not return them, you must do your restitution. Go and look for those people. Go and look for them, confess, and do your restitution today. Do your restitution today. All those books you have taken, the money you have taken, you never return, do your restitution today. Now is the time to restitute. Or did you buy some items and you never paid back? Maybe you said you went to your neighbor, Mama, see, please, can I buy something from you? I'll give you money later. And you never paid back. You never paid back. Because I know in some countries, you can go to a neighbor or to a friend that is telling something. Can I get something from you? And you never paid. I pray the Holy Spirit begin to remind you of everything in the name of Jesus. And you never paid back. Or you borrow money from your neighbor. You borrow money from your friend and you never paid back. The money should be paid. You cannot owe no man. You cannot owe any man. You cannot owe any man. If you owe a man, you can't get to heaven. If you have borrowed money from friends, from neighbors, from your organization, from anywhere, from the government, you must pay back. You must pay back. Or maybe women to women in the kitchen, you wanted to take something, the other woman is not there in the kitchen, and you just took it without informing the lady. And after you have taken it, you did not even go back to say, oh, I have done this thing, I have taken your salt, I have taken you the Maggie, I have taken this, I have taken that. Those things may be minor. They may look simple. But please, it is better you do your restitution now than later that you say, depart from me. Because of ordinary magic, the Lord God Almighty will help you. He will help me in the name of Jesus. Amen. So those things you have taken without permission, you must restitute today. So that all those things will not wait for you at the gate of heaven. Those things will not wait for you at the gate of heaven. We are talking to heaven seekers here. I'm not talking to all believers. No. Because I know some believers will say she's talking rubbish. They will say she's talking nonsense. So I'm not talking to all believers. I am talking only to heaven seekers. Only those that want to make heaven. Those are the ones God has sent me to today by the grace of God. And I pray the Almighty God will help you to make full restitution in Jesus' name. Amen. What about fraudulent activities? All fraudulent activities. Maybe you are a contractor. You have inflated the quotes. You know, you have given a company a quote, you inflated it. Or you could now be somebody in that company and say, add this amount to it. So that when you have been awarded the contract, you now begin to share the remaining money, the inflated one. You must go back, confess it, and make your restitution today. All those inflated concessions, you know, you as a contractor, or you have connected with somebody to add money to something that you're not supposed to, go back, confess, and restitute today in the name of Jesus. Or are you the head of the department? And you begin to tell people that are bringing quotations to you to add your own portion. They should add your own portion. They should add your own portion. All those portions, you must confess them and restitute them today in the name of Jesus. Everything. You must do everything because you are now a new creature. Because you are now a new creature, you must confess and restitute everything. You must restitute all the money you've embezzled. All the money you've embezzled, you must restitute them today. All bribes you've taken. All bribes you've taken. All corruption. They must all be returned. What about wrong and what about you being an another person's credit card? Maybe you saw another person's credit card, or you had the opportunity to have the credit card number and you used it. Now you are a child of God. You must go back, confess, and make your restitution. If you have used another person's credit card to buy something, either you stole it or you use it without permission. Either you stole that credit card or you use it without permission, you must restitute all. Everything you have stolen, everything you have taken without permission, you must restitute all. And all of them must be done today. They must all be restituted as soon as possible. Start it now. The Lord God will help you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. We will go to the fourth one. Restitution in ministry. Restitution in ministry, in ministerial work. In ministerial work, as a child of God, as a minister. You as a pastor or minister of the gospel. So this portion is for ministers of God, pastors, workers in the vineyard of God that want to make heaven. Those that are determined to make heaven. If you do not have a clear record about tithe and offering in the time past, now you have to put record straight. Pastor, minister, worker, HOD, any post you are holding in the church, and you are being exposed to tithe and offering, and you are not being faithful in that area, you must confess them now. Make record straight. Do your restitution. Do your restitution today. Confess them before it's too late. Bury the shame for you to make heaven at last, for you to have eternal life. Bury the shame, brethren, for you to have eternal life. So, if you have had a shady business in the past, maybe you connect with another minister of God. You must confess it now. You have connected with another person, either a worker in the church or another minister. You must make things right. You must put your record straight. You must make things right now. You must put everything right now. Confess them before your congregation. If you have done anything evil in the past, if you have sacrificed any animal in the church, if you have killed any human being to make people come to your church, to make a lot of people come to your church, now you are a born again Christian. Now you've repented. You need to confess them all. You need to confess them all before your members, not just one person or a group, before your members. If you have sacrificed anything, if you have been involved in any shady things in the past, but now you have surrendered your life fully and sincerely to the Almighty God and you want to make heaven, you must make that open confession. You must make that open confession to your members. All the members, not to one person, or to your husband, or to your wife, or to a group, or to the leaders in the church alone. No. This one involves the whole member of the church. So you must confess them to the congregation. Amen. Let's read again the book of 1 Samuel. 1 Samuel chapter 12. 1 Samuel chapter 12 verses 1-5. And Samuel said unto all Israel, Behold, I have hearkened unto your voice, in all that ye said unto me, and have made a king over you. And now, behold, the king walketh before you, and I am old and gray-headed. And behold, my sons are with you, and I have walked before you from my childhood unto this day. Behold, here I am, witness against me before the Lord, and before his anointed. Whose ox have I taken? Or whose ass have I taken? Or whom have I defrauded? Whom have I oppressed? Or of whom hand have I received any bribe to blind my eyes therewith? And I will restore it you. And they said, Thou hast not defrauded us, nor oppressed us, neither hast thou taken aught of any man's hand. And he said unto them, The Lord is witness against you, and his anointed is witness this day, that ye have not found aught in my hand. And they answered, He is witness. Amen. This is Samuel, a minister of the gospel, a minister of God. He made record straight. He claimed his record. He was ready to make restitution if there's anything at all. He asked every one of them. And they all said, No, you did not do it. Can you boldly receive that answer from your congregation today as a minister of the gospel? That is why you need to do your restitution today. You need to do your restitution, and that restitution should start now. We should live blameless life as ministers of the gospel. We saw it in the life of Samuel, where we just read. We saw it in the life of Samuel. He lived a blameless life. He was a minister. As a minister, as a pastor, as a worker in the church, you need to live a blameless life. All qualities you are placed by removing the rightful person from a particular branch of the church and transferring him or her to another parish unjust must be confessed and restituted. You as a pastor, as a minister, if you are in the position of removing and transferring pastors, and you have transferred some pastors unjustly, you have transferred some people unjustly, while the Lord has not laid it in your heart to do, you have done it unjustly, you must confess them all and do your restitution. You must confess them all and do your restitution now. The Lord is still, the mercy of the Lord is still available. The mercy of the Lord is still available. Because if you do all that and you do not restitute, that will wait for you at the heaven gate. That which you have done will wait for you at the gate of heaven. So, brethren, I beg you, please, do your restitution today in the name of Jesus. Open confession, confess to your members any unjust thing you have done as a pastor, as a minister. Open. Some pastors, some ministers are even sleeping with church members. That is the truth. Oh, yeah, it happens like 90% of churches that sing. Some pastors, some ministers, some workers, some members are sleeping with themselves right inside the same church. You must do your restitution today. Confess it. Or maybe they have even accused you before. They say, we saw you with so, and you denied it. Then you denied it because you were still a child of the devil, but now you're a child of God. You must go back and tell them, that lie I told about that relationship, I had with that brother. I had with that sister. I told a lie. Now, I'm telling the truth. It was true. We dated. True, we did this. Confess them and make that restitution, make the record straight. Now, if you are a pastor or a minister, you must confess this before your congregation. If you are a pastor or a minister, you must confess this before your congregation. Pray. I pray the Lord will give you the grace in the name of Jesus. So ministers are just sleeping with themselves. Day in, day out. They are just, all workers are committing immorality. All this must be restituted. If you are guilty of willfully changing the plans of God, if you are guilty of willfully changing the plans of God for a brother's marriage, maybe a brother came to you, oh, pastor, I had a dream, or the Lord spoke to me, this sister is going to be my bride, will be my wife. And maybe the pastor already has been eyeing that sister. And the brother came to you and told you as a pastor, you know, this is what God laid in my heart concerning this sister, that God says she's going to be my wife. And pastor said, okay, we'll pray about it. And you did not even bother to pray about it. And you now say, this brother that doesn't have a job, how can you receive this kind of sister? No, I will, in your own heart, you now say you will do something. You now went ahead and you gave that sister's hand in marriage to another brother who is rich. And you say you saw a vision. And you say you saw a vision. And you, that sister is now married to a wrong brother. You have destroyed the plans of God for concerning that sister. You have destroyed the plans of God concerning that brother. Pastor, minister, you must go back. Confess that which you have done and do your restitution today. If you have told a lie to one particular brother that say, hey, I pray that sister is not your wife. You must go back and confess to that brother and apologize and do your restitution. I hope it's not too late. I hope and I pray it's not too late. If you have given another sister out of marriage to another wrong brother, wrong sister to a wrong brother, you have to confess them. Either you do it by tricks or by working on their intelligence or by the information you gathered, you have to confess them and restitute. All immorality, all adultery, all flexing that you've committed outside the church, inside the church, you must confess them all. As a pastor, as a minister, as a worker in the vineyard of God, confess them. If there is any sister that was pregnant for you, confess them. If you have even given them money for abortion, confess them. Confess them today. Do your restitution. If there's any sister that was pregnant for you and you aborted the pregnancy, you must confess them. Confess them. Return from it. Do your restitution. Do your restitution. If there's any abortion, or maybe you have dated any lady in any department of the church at all, from the usher, from the Sunday school teacher, from the choir, from anywhere, move your restitution and make it right today in the name of Jesus. If you have been confronted before about anything that is said, pastor or a minister or a worker or a member of the church, they have confronted you before about an issue and you denied it, you have to go back now and say, that time I lied, now I'm saying the truth. This is the truth. And let them know the truth. The Bible says, you shall know the truth. And that truth which you have known is the one that will set you free. Amen. So, everything you have denied before, you have to go back and say the truth now. Say all the truth. The fake prophecy you gave. Pastor, you have given fake prophecies many times for you to get money from your members. Pastors, ministers, you have given fake prophecies for you to get money from your members. You must confess them now. Confess before your congregation and do your restitution. Confess it before your congregation. All the fake prophecies you have given. All the fake prophecies you have given. Confess them now. Before your congregation and do your restitution and make things right. I pray the Lord God will give as many ministers out there that are able to seek us the grace to do all this in Jesus' name. Amen. And we go to the last one, number 5. Restitution is necessary in marriage. In marriage. First, I would like to explain the difference between fornication and adultery. Because a passage of people do not understand fully the difference between fornication and adultery. Now, what is fornication? Because fornication is different from adultery. Fornication is different from adultery. Fornication is the sin committed by unmarried people. Fornication is the sin committed by unmarried people when they sleep together. When two unmarried people sleep together, what they did together is called fornication. While adultery is a sin committed by married people, when two married people sleep together outside their married bed, outside their wedlock, what they have done is called adultery. Or in a case whereby if a married man sleeps with a single sister, that married man has committed adultery, while that sister who is not married has committed fornication. Or as the case may be, maybe a married woman committed adultery with a single brother. That single brother committed fornication. Amen. I hope you now understood the difference between adultery and fornication. Amen. So, now, when you are married, because now you, I believe you have now understood the difference between fornication and adultery. Now, for married women, for now that you are married, you are one with your spouse. If you are married, you are one with your spouse. Because the Bible says, if you will leave your father, a man will leave his father and his mother and be clean to his wife, and his twain shall become one. So you and your wife, you are one. You and your husband, you are one. You are one with your spouse. Therefore, no divorce. No divorce. No divorce. No matter what happens in that marriage, no divorce. Marriage is for life. The only separation is death. Marriage is for life. The only separation is death. Amen. As a married woman, if you have used charms, to chain a man to your bed, you have used a charm, or you have used charms to marry a man, you must confess it to. You must repent, confess, and do your restitution. If you are a woman, you have used charms to woo a man, to make a man love you, and that man is in your trap today, and now you are a child of God, you have to remember that thing you did, and you must repent of it, you must confess it, and do your restitution. Do your restitution. By first, by repenting, you have to go back to where you have done it and release that man. After you release him, you confess it to the man and you leave the marriage. You must do your restitution. The Lord will grant you the grace in the name of Jesus. If you have a child or children outside your marital home, you have slept with another man and you got pregnant, and you know this particular child, or these two children, or these three children among the seven you have had, they are not for your husband. You must confess them to your husband. You must confess them to your husband. All those things, confess everything to your husband and do your restitution. Do your restitution. If you have had a child or children outside your marital home, you must confess it. Or in a case whereby you are the second wife, though you know the first wife, both the first and the second wife, you live together in your husband's house. Or you are the third wife, the fourth wife, the fifth wife, everybody, they live together. You must leave that marriage. If you are a second wife, third wife, fourth wife, fifth wife, sixth wife, no matter the number of you are, if you are not the first wife, you must leave that marriage. You must do your restitution. Except the first wife of that man is dead. If the first wife is dead and you are the second, you can stay in the marriage. But if the first wife is dead, you are not the second. The second is still alive, you must leave that marriage. If the first and the second are dead, and you are the third or the fourth, you are still, as long as that third is still alive, you have to leave that marriage. No matter the number of the wife you are, if you are number second and the first wife is still alive, you must leave the marriage. You must do your restitution. You must leave the marriage. Or if you have been married to a man who was married before, in a case whereby this man was married before, and the wife is still alive. If the wife is still alive, and you are a single lady, you never married before, but you got married to a man that has been married before, and the woman is still alive, you have to leave that marriage. Despite that he is your first husband. As long as the man was married before and the wife is still alive, you must leave that marriage. You must leave that home. It's not your place. Though the man may be your first husband, but as long as the man was married before, and the man, maybe he has married 2, 3, 4 wives before, and any of the wives before you is still alive, you must leave that marriage. You must leave the marriage and do your restitution. Though you may be the first husband, you know, in the case of a man, if you are a man and you got married to a woman, and that woman is your first wife, but the woman already married to another man and got divorced, the man is still alive. As long as the man is still alive, you have to leave that woman alone. Leave the marriage. Though the woman may be your first wife, you have to leave the marriage. Do your restitution today. You must leave that marriage in the name of Jesus. Amen. Let's look at the Bible. Let's look at the Bible in the book of Mark. Mark chapter 10. Let's go to Mark. Mark chapter 10, verses. Mark chapter 10. Yeah, verses 1 to 12. But I will just read verses. You can read verses 1 to 12 in your own time, but I will just read from verses 10 to 12 here because of our time. And in the house, his disciple asked him again of the same matter. And he said unto them, whosoever shall put away his wife and marry another committed adultery against her. And if a woman shall put away her husband and be married to another, she committed adultery. Did you hear that? This one is from the Bible. This is the word of the Lord. This is the word of the Lord Jesus Christ himself when he was still here. So, you cannot put away your wife. And if that should happen, if you got divorced and you are the first wife, you are the first husband, you must go back to your first husband. You must go back to your first wife. You must go back to your first husband. You must go back to your first wife, because no divorcee will see heaven. Amen. Restitution must be done thoroughly. Restitution must be done thoroughly. If you are taking your friend's husband, because some ladies out there, when they come visit you for the first time, they will see your husband. This man. I like this. I like that. And callingly, you are taking your friend's husband, or you are taking your friend's wife. You must confess it. That maybe you lied, that we met before you met, before you came together, and all that, all those lies, all those things you cooked up for you to take another man's wife, a family's friend, you must confess them all. You must confess them all. Confess everything. Now, in the name of Jesus. Because now you are a child of God and you want to make heaven. Do your restitution. Restitution is making peace with your opponent. Restitution is making peace with your opponent. We are going to read the book of Matthew. Matthew chapter 5. Matthew chapter 5. We'll be reading verses 23 and 24. Matthew chapter 5, 23 and 24. Therefore, if thou bring thy gift to the altar, and there rememberest that thy brother hath ought against thee, leave there thy gift before the altar, and go thy way. First be reconciled to thy brother, and then come and offer thy gift. Did you hear that? If your brother is at fault, that's ought at you, you must first, and you have gifts in your hand to present to God, you must first lay your gift aside. Go to that person, go and reconcile. Then you come back and present your gift to the Lord. By that time, your gift, the Lord will accept it. The Lord will accept your gift by so doing. So if you ever cheated on your wife, if you ever cheated on your husband, if you ever cheated at all at married couple, you must let him or her know and do your restitution. Let your husband know about it. Let your wife know about it and do your restitution. I pray the Holy Spirit will lead you. He will make you to confess and he will go before you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Wives that take money from their husband's wallet. Wives, if you take money from your husband's wallet without his permission, without him knowing, please confess it to them now. Please confess it to your husband now. And husbands, please forgive your wives when they come to you after taking so money from your pocket, from your wallet. Please forgive them. Please forgive them. Wives that have taken money from their husband's wallet, you must make restitution. Make restitution of all evil done. Make restitution of all wickedness that you have done to your spouse. All wickedness that you have done to your spouse, either to your husband or your wife, all wickedness, all evil you have done, you must do restitution. Wives, be submissive to your husbands. Wives, be submissive to your husbands. And husbands, love your wives dearly. Love your wife dearly, because no divorcee will enter heaven. Wives, be submissive. Husbands, love your wives dearly, because no divorcee will make heaven if you do not make restitution. If you did not make restitution, no divorcee will enter heaven. You have to make your restitution today in the name of Jesus. Amen. I know all these things are difficult with some people. You know, I know all these things are really difficult for some people. But with prayers and counsel, you can do it. The Lord will go before you. The Lord will go before you if you, in the name of Jesus. And if you have committed incest, like sleeping with your own brother, or sleeping with your own sister, sleeping with your cousin, sleeping with auntie, sleeping with nephew, as long as you are blood related, those are incest. If you have committed any of it, you must confess them. Confess them, do your restitution. You can call up your parents, or any people in your family, let them know. This is what you have done. Let them forgive you so that God can forgive you as well. So all the incest you have committed, confess them. You must confess them and do your restitution. And if you have committed an abortion before, confess it to your husband. Maybe you were single, you committed abortion before you got married. Now you are married. Let your husband know. And if you are still single, when you are going to get married, you are sure this man is going to marry you, confess this to your husband to be before you get married. Before you get married. Confess it to your husband to be. You have done this, you have done this. If you have done any abortion before, you must confess it. You must tell your husband Do not be afraid. The Lord will go with you in the name of Jesus. The Lord will always go before you. If you do it in prayers, if you do your restitution in prayer, you do your restitution with all humility. You do your restitution with all humility, with sincere hearts. Because God sees your heart. God sees your heart. If you are doing it with sincere hearts, with all humility, with prayers, the Lord will go with you. Do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. Restitution is wisdom. Restitution is wisdom. The Lord will grant us the grace in Jesus' name. And if your case requires counsel, please seek counsel. If your own case requires counsel, please seek counsel. With all this we have said, you may say, why do we need restitution? With all this we have said, you may say, why do we need restitution? We need restitution because you are now a new creature. We need restitution because you are now a new person. We need restitution because you are a new person inside and outside. We need restitution because you are now saved. Number two, the second reason why you need restitution is because you want to obey God and do His will. The reason why you must do your restitution is because you want to obey God. You want to do God's will. And God's will is divine. God's will is perfect. God's will will lead you to heaven in the name of Jesus. The number three reason is for you to clear your conscience. To clear your conscience, to have a clear conscience. And number four is to show a sample for others. Because when you do your own restitution, you are showing a sample to other Christians. You are showing a sample to other sinners. Because when another child of God sees you do your restitution, say, oh, my own restitution is not even as bad as this. Let me go ahead and do mine. And even by doing that, we are showing restitution, we are showing good example to sinners. It's now say, oh, so it's good to serve Jesus like this. This man came back to me and apologized and confessed all this. I will give my life to Christ. You see, the restitution is very necessary. So you are going to show good example for others to follow. Amen. And number five reason is for your soul to escape eternal death. Your soul will escape eternal death by doing your restitution. When you do your restitution right, without sincerity, when you do it fully, your soul will escape eternal death. Amen. Number six reason is to be delivered from curses. As we saw when we read in the book of Judges with Micah and his mom. You know, the mother cursed. And you do not know how many curses have been upon your life. Because of the wrong you have done in the past. So, by you doing your restitution, you will be delivered from curse or from curses, as the case may be. The number seven reason is to follow peace with all men. When you do your restitution, you follow peace with all men. He will give you peace with God and peace with all men. He will help you to follow peace with all men. And lastly, to be careful not to commit another sin. Because when you do your restitution, it will help you to be careful not to do another sin, because it is costly to restitute. Oh, brethren, it is costly to restitute. For you to go back, to now say, you know what, I bypassed about this, I told a lie about this. It is costly to be going back and be saying all those things. And between putting things right, it is costly. So, by doing your restitution, it will help you to daily check yourself. So that you don't have to go back and be doing restitution again. It will help you to be careful not to commit another sin. Because it is costly to restitute. Amen. Brethren, if your heart is not circumcised, it will be difficult to do restitution. Either of the things of the past or of present. If your heart is not circumcised, that was why I made mention of some of the preachings we have posted on this forum before, that you need to listen to them before this. If this is your first message you are listening to, I would please advise to go back to those ones we already posted on this forum. The first one is the mandate of heaven. The second one is the repentance from the earth. The third one is physician, heal yourself. The first one is salvation, sanctification after salvation. Then this one, restitution for heaven's seekers. Please, brethren, make sure your heart is circumcised. Because when your heart is not circumcised, it will be difficult to do restitution. It will be difficult to do restitution either from the past or of present. If you are indeed born again, it will not be difficult. It will not be difficult to go back and rectify your past. It will not be difficult for you to go back and rectify your past. Going forward, you refrain from gossips. Because restitution is costly. So from now on, please refrain from gossips. Refrain from anger, from malice, from all those things. Refrain from backbiting. Refrain from unfaithfulness. Refrain from false witness. Refrain from all those things so that you don't go back and begin to do restitution all over again. Please refrain from them. Make sure you settle with God first. Please make sure you settle with God first. Then go and settle with men. When you have settled with God, then you cannot go ahead and settle with men. Brothers and sisters, I tell you, you cannot hide it from God. You cannot hide that sin from God. If you cover your sin and say nobody sees you, and say nobody knows, you cannot hide it from God, brethren. Remember, God sees and knows all things. God is omniscient. You cannot hide it from God at all. You cannot hide it from God. Will you surrender your life to Christ if you have not surrendered your life to Christ today? If you have not surrendered to Christ, you cannot even do this. I have already explained that. So if you want to surrender your life to Christ today, as we round up, if you want to surrender your life to Christ today, I want to give your life to Christ. I will say that the time for you is now. If you have not given your life to Christ, the time for you to surrender your life to Christ is now, because tomorrow may not come. Tomorrow may not come. If you are ready to surrender your life to Christ, brethren, I would like to pray with you, if you don't mind. I would like to pray with you, if you don't mind, if you want to surrender your life to Christ, shall we pray? Shall we pray? Please, let's close our eyes and pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Please say this prayer after me if you want to surrender your life to Christ afresh, or you want to rededicate your life to Christ. Please say this prayer after me. Amen. Lord Jesus, I come to you today. I set you today as my Lord and personal Savior. I know you died for me. I know you shed your blood on the cross of Calvary for me. I confess all my sins and I repent of them. Let that blood you shed wash me from all sin. Let your blood cleanse me from all sin. Write my name in the book of life. Give me the grace to sin no more. Give me the power to say no to sin. Give me the grace to overcome sin. Prepare me for heaven, O Lord. Grant me the grace, O God, to live daily victorious life. Keep me to the end, Lord. Keep me to the end. Make me ready for your coming. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. If you have said that prayer after me, let us pray this prayer. Father, Lord Jesus, I want to commit your children that have just surrendered their lives or that have dedicated their lives unto you into your hands. You are the only one who can save. No man can save but you. Father, I pray, save the souls of this one Have they have genuinely repented of their sins and they have come to you, they have accepted you as their Lord and Savior. Please save their souls in the name of Jesus. Father, please write their names in the book of life and grant them the grace and power to overcome all sins in Jesus' name. Give them grace to sin no more. Give them the power to overcome the power of sin in Jesus' name. I break every power of sin in your life today in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for you alone, our God. Blessed be your name, O Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. Amen. Amen, amen. And right now, I want to pray for as many that are ready to do restitution, as many that you are ready, you are determined, that you want to do your restitution now. I'm going to pray with you in the name of Jesus. Shall we pray in Jesus' name? Most faithful Father, most righteous Father, most gracious Father, we worship you. Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, King of Glory, we adore you. We thank you for your word that have gone forth today. We thank you for your word that have gone forth with power. With power, oh Lord. We give you praise, Jesus. We give you honor, Jesus. We give you all adoration, Jesus. We pray, oh Lord God Almighty, for your children that are determined to make restitutions today. Your children that are determined to make the wrong things right today. Father, grant them the grace. Grant them the power. Grant them the enablement. Grant them the strength. Holy Spirit, go before them as they go ahead to make their restitution. Oh, Father, be with them. Speak to them. Lead them. Help them to seek godly counsel. Help them to seek godly counsel. As many that need counsel, Father, lead them to the right counsel, Lord. That we counsel them in our truth. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Oh, Lord, I say, as many of your children that are determined that made up their mind to do their restitution today. Father, help them. Only please help them. Lord Jesus, help them to do their restitution and to do it fully in the name of Jesus. Grant them the grace to do it faithfully and with all joy in the name of Jesus. Grant them to grace, O God, that they will not fall into this same sin again in Jesus' name. You will not fall into sin again in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Blessed be your name, O Lord. Glory, honor be unto your name, our Redeemer. Oh, because you are so good. You are so good to us, Jehovah. We give you praise. We thank you, O Lord. Blessed be your name. Thank you, our Redeemer. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. Amen. Amen. We thank God. This has brought us to the end of today's message. But before we go, by the grace of God, we will pray again for as many children of the Most High God. You are genuinely saved and you need healing in your body, in any part of your body. Any part of your body that you need healing and you want God to heal you. He will heal you now. All you have to do is to exercise faith. Have faith that Christ is the one that will heal, that will heal you and is ready to heal you now. Shall we pray in Jesus' name? Father, Lord, most high, I pray for your children, as many of your children, O God, that are sick and are not in good health right now, that are not in perfect health right now. I pray for your healing virtues to flow through them now, in the name of Jesus. I pray for healing from the Almighty God, divine healing to fall upon your children. Is it cancer? Is it terminal disease? Whatsoever it may be called, whatsoever name it may be called, as many of your faithful children that are sick right now, I receive divine healing for you in Jesus' name. I rebuke sickness in your life in the name of Jesus. I rebuke sickness over you now in the name of Jesus. I take your blood, your flesh, your bones, your marrow, your veins, the water in you receives healing now. Your joints receives healing. Pain in the back receives healing now. In the name of Jesus. Chest pain receives healing now. In the name of Jesus. Pain in that right limb. Pain in that right limb. I command the healing of the Lord to come over you in that right limb now. In the name of Jesus. Pain all over your body. I command divine healing to come over you now in Jesus' name. Pain in your palms. Your two palms. You feel pain on your palms. I command the healing of the Lord God Almighty to fall upon you now in the name of Jesus. Divine Father, everlasting Father, God that has healing on his wings, heal your children, O Lord.
Heal your children, O Lord. Heal your children, O Lord. In the name of Jesus. Thank you for your healing. Father, I pray that the healing upon your children's life will be permanent in Jesus' name. Thank you, our Father. Blessed be your name, O Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. Amen, 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 amen. We bless God for today. We give God all the glory. We give God all the honor. We want to say thank you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you for taking time to listen to today's message from the Lord God Almighty. The Lord be with you. The Lord guide you, protect and bring you. Till next time, if Jesus tarry, we shall meet next time on this forum in the name of Jesus. We're going to worship God with this song before we share the grace. Amen. Unto the Lord be the glory. Great things he has done. Unto the Lord be the glory. Great things he has done. Unto you, Lord, be the glory. Great things he has done. Unto you, Lord, be the glory. Great things you have done. Great things you have done. Great things you will do. Unto you, Lord, be the glory. Great things you have done. Unto Jesus be the glory. Great things you have done. Unto you, Lord, be the glory. Great things you have done. Amen. Oh, unto you, Jesus, be the glory. Great things, mighty things, marvelous things, excellent things, divine things, things you have done. Oh, Lord, we are grateful. Unto you be all the glory. Unto you be all honor, all adoration. No man shall share your glory with you. To you alone be all the glory. To you alone be all the honor. To you alone be all adoration. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you for being with us today, Father. We appreciate you. Glory be to your name for that which you have done. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. Amen. 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 We bless God. We give God the glory for today. We give God all honor, all adoration. Thank you, Jesus. We appreciate you. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, Lord, we appreciate you. Thank you, brethren. Thank you, brothers and sisters. God bless you. Till we meet next time, the Lord will be with you. He will guide you. He will answer all your requests in the name of Jesus. He will grant you peace in Jesus' name. Shall we share the grace in fellowship? May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the presence of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Amen, brethren. Amen. God bless you. God be with you. Till we meet next time, the Lord bless you. He protects and bring you back when Jesus tarries, in Jesus' name. Shalom. God bless you.